Hi, today we're going to talk about Windows Server 2012 networking and specifically network virtualization. We're going to go through the concepts of network virtualization and then show you how easy it is to deploy multi-tenant secure and isolated environments utilizing Windows Server 2012. Hyper-V network virtualization extends the concept of server virtualization to allow multiple virtual networks to be deployed on the same physical network. You can set policies that isolate network traffic from different business units or customers on a shared network without using traditional virtual local area networks or VLANs. And this is where the magic starts. You see, VLANs can become complex on a large scale, and they can have a serious effect on flexibility and agility. By eliminating the need for VLANs, you get an infrastructure that responds immediately to your changing environment. This diagram illustrates how you can use Hyper-V network virtualization to isolate network traffic belonging to two different customers. In the figure, blue and red virtual machines are hosted on a single physical network or even the same physical server. However, because they belong to separate virtual networks, the virtual machines can't communicate with each other, even if the customers assign them IP addresses from the same address space. With Hyper-V network virtualization, the possibilities are almost endless. Let's say you want to move virtual machines around in your virtual infrastructure without losing their network assignments. No problem. Or imagine you need to integrate a private network into a pre-existing infrastructure on another site, or even a hosted environment. You can do that too. Ultimately, you can get much more flexibility because Hyper-V network virtualization provides an alternative to rigid VLANs and eliminates hierarchical IP address assignments. Servers keep their internal IP addresses while you move workloads onto shared infrastructure as a cloud, minimizing the need for configuration changes. Server workload placement is also simplified because migration and placement of workloads are independent of the underlying physical network configurations. As such, services and workloads can now be placed or migrated to any server in the data center while keeping their IP addresses without being limited to a physical IP subnet hierarchy or VLAN configuration. So here we have Virtual Machine Manager as part of System Center 2012 V.next. That's managing my Windows Server 2012 virtual machine environment. You can see a number of organizations that are already taking advantage of multi-tenancy built on Windows Server 2012, and I can easily administer them through my VMM console. In fact, we have three organizations with the same IP subnet. The great thing here is they're fully isolated, fully secured from each other, even though they may be using the same physical network. This is one of the great powers that multi-tenancy can provide both service providers and also organizations looking to secure divisions in their own IT infrastructure. In fact, you can see here that I have Tailspin Toys and Contoso Pharmaceuticals, and all these organizations are utilizing the 10.0.0.1 IP address for their main websites, but they're fully isolated from each other, even though they may be running on the same server and on the same physical network. Now, creating a new multi-tenant environment utilizing virtual machine networking is really simple with VMM tool. And in fact, you could do this with Windows Server 2012 PowerShell as well, so allowing you to utilize the tool that you're most comfortable with. I simply click on Create VM Network. In this case, I'm going to create it for a company called Fourth Coffee. I choose the logical network. I'm going to choose the shared network, which is the logical network set up for all my hosted environment that is allowing multi-tenancy. The next thing we'll do is create a VM subnet. Now, the VM subnet could actually be requested by a customer to allow for IP portability, or actually provided to me by a hoster or a service provider. The great thing here is because we're a fully multi-tenant environment, we can actually use the same subnets that we've used before without the fear of any cross information. In this case, we'll use the 10.0.0 subnet that we've used for Contoso and Tailspin, and still ensuring fully multi-tenant environments for all those organizations. Now that I've finished creating that new network, what I need to do is go and create an IP pool that allows IP addresses to be available for all the virtual machines that will be hosted in that environment. So I'm just going to create a new IP pool here. And you can see that it's automatically filled in the virtual machine network and also the VM subnet. It's also providing me an IP address range, and I can go and modify that IP address range if I want based on the number of addresses that I require. I can also provide gateway information, DNS, WINs, and other information associated with that as well. So you can see that it was super simple to create this multi-tenant environment and then assign an IP address range for that, and now I can actually go and deploy virtual machines to this straight away. Now, deploying virtual machines in my new multi-tenant environment is super simple. I can do this through Virtual Machine Manager utilizing templates, or I can automate this utilizing system templates with System Center 2012. Let me show you a quick example of doing this through Virtual Machine Manager. I'm going to create a new virtual machine from one of our templates. I'm going to choose an existing template, which is based on Windows Server 2012. I'm going to name this server 401. And in the configure hardware, what I'm going to do is I'm going to scroll down to the networking, and I'm going to choose to select the VM network. In this case, I'm going to choose my fourth coffee network and the fourth coffee subnet. So I'm going to automatically join this virtual machine into that multi-tenant environment of my fourth coffee organization. Here I'm going to choose to deploy my virtual machine on the host. I'm now going to select the host that I want to put this virtual machine on. In this case, I'm going to put it on my DO8 SRV01 server. I can now configure more specific settings associated with that virtual machine. In this case, I'm just going to leave that as default. I can also add other properties if I so desire. And you can see here that I get a summary view. The great thing here is I can hit the View Script button, and I can actually view the PowerShell script that is going to be used to deploy this virtual machine into my multi-tenant environment. Now all I do is have to hit the Create button, and that virtual machine is now being created for my customer, stored in their multi-tenant environment, utilizing Virtual Machine Manager. Thank you.